you feel life is beautiful? Can you see the hands? How many of you feel life is a burden? For me, life has always felt like a burden until 2 years ago. And today I'm going to share with you the interesting story of how I calibrated myself from a low life condition to a high life condition. Good morning, Toastmasters and dear guests.
Good morning.
I, Sunaina Agarwal, was born and brought up in Kolkata. Being the youngest of three daughters in a Marwari family, I've always led a sheltered life. Each and every decision of my life has always been taken either by my parents or my elder sisters. From clothes to boyfriends, everything was always decided by them. Being the mollycoddle child, I never really got the chance to develop my decision-making skills. Everything was decided for me, and this led to me developing negative self-beliefs and limiting beliefs about my own self. I was subconsciously programmed into becoming a people pleaser. I always wanted to be a journalist or a public speaker. However, I could never voice my opinion in front of my parents, as I knew any such wish would be opposed by a "we know what's best for you" by my parents. That was my first sacrifice, my career choice. I was pushed into CA, I became a CA, and I worked as one for 10 years. I had moved into a people-pleasing mode. Subconsciously, I would keep doing things to please others, even if it meant it was hurting me from inside. So much so that while getting married, I selected a life partner who belonged to my own caste, just because I knew that that was the only attribute that was pleased by parents. Later on, I suffered through an abusive marriage. However, walking out was not an option because it could not please my parents. The turning point of my life came in 2017, when I realized how exhausted I was from working in a job that gave me no happiness and being in a relationship that was draining my energies from all sides. I asked myself, why did I need to sacrifice my happiness in every aspect of my life? My wish to be truly happy from within and to live for myself led me to two conclusions. First, if I wanted to be happy, I had to act. And second, there would be no knight in shining armor to rescue me. I had to become one and rescue myself. This realization culminated in me taking the two major decisions of my life by myself, which have made my life beautiful. Any guesses? Quitting my job and leaving my husband. These decisions were made just to please my own self. Mind it, they did not please the others. And what wonderful decisions they have been, for they have helped me live in true authenticity and true to who I am. My life may not be perfect, but who cares for perfection when you have joy, happiness, and freedom? Am I judged? Yes. Do I care? No. From a disillusioned person to an enlightened individual, my life has come to a full circle. In this regard, I would like to quote the poet Rumi. You are not a drop in the ocean. You are not a drop in the ocean. You are the entire ocean in a drop. Thank you. Today, I am a successful wellness coach and a trainer. Today, I am a successful wellness coach and trainer. I'm free to choose my options and to make my own decisions. And the best part about this is that this has helped me become aware of my life's purpose of helping others come out of their own limiting beliefs and subconscious programming. And helping me achieve these goals is our beautiful organization, Toastmasters, where I learn something new every day. I truly believe that joining Toastmasters